Monet, and I rap.
Said you better get the wax out of your hairy ears, because you cannot hear. I made it very clear. You see, I ain't no victim, that cannot be. And if I ever been gripped, no, it ain't me. Stop bugging, drugging, fucking perpetrators. It's a man with a plan to make you think your enemy is me. Don't buy it, try this.
People tend to think, oh, you've got it made because you're different. White female rapper, perfect marketing thing. But I was always real interested in the music and being true to the music. And to me, I didn't want to sign with anyone that couldn't help me make the music good. It's not just about laying down some dollars. It's about doing beats and doing music and loving rap.
Do you feel it's difficult being accepted by a black audience because you're white?
I think the initial reaction can sometimes be harsh and really judgmental. And I think that there is racism everywhere. What I learned is I honestly believe, and I know it to be true, because it's happening with groups like Third Base. If you are good, if you are true to the culture and respectful of where that comes from, you will be accepted.
Some think that we can't flow. Stereotypes, they got to go. I'ma mess around and flip the scene into reverse.
With what?
With a little touch of ladies first.
The major success stories in rap are black males. Most females up till now have been sort of the only time they've done a rap, they've been answering a guy's rap about then.
Ladies first.
Yeah, there's gonna be some changes right here.
Who said that the ladies couldn't make it? You must be blind. If you don't believe what here, listen to this rhyme. Ladies first, take no time to rehearse. I'm divine and my mind expands throughout the universe.
Now there's females in rap that are just really putting some serious science, as we say, down. Latifah, MC Light, you know, you don't think of them as being female rappers. They're just great rappers. They put out great records.
Funky fresh dress to impress, ready to party. Money in your pocket, dying to move your body. To get inside, you pay the whole $10. Scotch tape with a razor blade, tape to your collar. Leave the guns in the crack and the knobs alone. MC Light's on the microphone. Bum rushing and pushing, snatching and taxing. I cram to understand why brothers don't be maxing. There's only one disco, they'll close one more. You ain't guarding the door, so what you got a gun for? Do you rob the rich and give to the poor? Yo, daddy, yo, school him some more.
People rap about everything under the sun. There's no one thing. You know, right now, the trend is for a lot of people to embrace the concept of Afrocentricity, which means having a worldview that's based from an African perspective as opposed to a Eurocentric perspective. So that means honoring, accepting, and acknowledging our value system in lieu of other people's value systems, and basically presenting things and saying things on our own terms, and forcing people to dialogue so that you can have what I would call true integration, meaning that you're a white guy, you have your way of viewing things, I'm a black guy, I have my way of viewing things. If we're gonna talk, we'll both put our views on the table and we'll walk away with each of it, not you feed it to me and I go, yes sir, that's good, and now I know. No, it's you learned from me, I learned from you. And that's the trend that's picked up by a lot of rappers now.
Mulan is the original name of Africa, now stripped of its fame. It's good to know that in ancient times, Egyptians developed all sciences of the mind to the point where they ruled the planet. But Rome, Greece, and Persia wasn't having it. They attacked and won the war, but it wasn't enough. They had to get to the core, because in that time it was Aki Mulan that ruled religion, politics, and man. In order to destroy the Egyptian race, they had to wipe the sciences from off the face of the planet. So they proceeded to ban it and replace it with Christianity. And it's been that way all the way to today. Learn what we teach, hear what we say.
The way it manifests itself is a lot of rappers rapping about the origins of black people, black and African cultural pride, positive things that address the social and societal ills that are afflicting us.
Face, how much can you smoke? One toe and a bubble chill. Once again, crack is the incredible. The devil's animal, it is an obstacle. I'm real cool, I chill to the max. I might act crazy, but I don't smoke crack. I'm real cool, I chill to the max. I might act crazy, but I don't smoke crack. So don't give me that middle one, that
thank you.
think of rap music?
What kind of music?
Rap music.
I don't know what it is.
Have you ever heard Public Enemy?
No, never have.
Kool Moe Dee?
No.
Queen Latifah?
No.
All right, turn around, this woman right here. What message do you think a lot of rap music sends to young people?
It's rebellious, which I guess is like all music, but it's more rebellious than pop music.
That's what they said about rock and roll when it started out.
That's true, it's true.
I like some of the rap music and I dislike others. I feel that it says a lot about the black culture, but sometimes it says it in a negative way and it could be more positive.
What are some of the negative things that you've heard?
Drugs, prison, crime, and I don't think these are the things that should be reflected in any kind of music. I think music should always be a positive projection and vehicle to society.
Well, you know, when you say that, and you go and look at the multi-million dollar films, and all the violence in these movies, and all the sex are in these movies, and all of the just out and out disrespect of women, rape, and so forth and so on, what's the difference? I mean, I feel that these kids see this every day, and all they're doing is expressing what they see. And I don't think they're advocating that blacks kill blacks, or that whites kill blacks and vice versa. I think they're just expressing what they feel and what they see. And I think it's a lot of pain coming out of this music too, because a lot of these kids are in an enormous amount of pain. And so this is their way of expressing. It's a far better situation when they express it this way than to go out there with a gun and blow somebody's brains out.
But guns they'll never find. My lethal weapon, my mind.
Are you disturbed at all about some of the violence that's associated with
Francis? Absolutely, absolutely. But Ice-T was correct. That's the life in the ghettos. You know, we had a big homicide rate here in Oakland last year. It's a huge homicide rate in Washington. So that's violence is happening. And the black kids are killing each other, but a hidden story that you don't read about very much is the white kids are killing themselves. The result is the same, right? People are dead. The young people are dead. So there's a crisis in this country. You have an economic crisis where you have families, not only single people, but families living in the streets. You have a pathology among blacks, but also among whites. So I don't know if this will be dismissed as subversive music, because apparently people are in power, are looking at it for the purpose of clamping down on it, which has always been the attitude toward African-American culture in this country.
Well, today's topic, self-destruction, it really ain't the rap audience that's bugging. It's one or two suckers, ignorant brothers, trying to rob and steal from one another. You get caught in the mid. So to crush that stereotype, here's what we did. We got ourselves together so that you could unite and fight for what's right. Not negative cause, the way we live is positive, we don't kill our relatives.
Pop, 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 when it's shot, who's to blame? Headline, front page, and rap's the name. MC Delight here to state the bottom line. The black on black crime was way before our time.
Took a brother's life with a knife at his wife. Cried cause he died of trifling death when he left his very last breath. Was I slept, so watch your step. Back in the 60s, our brothers and sisters were hanged. How could you gang bang? I never ever ran from the Ku Klux Klan, and I shouldn't have to run from a black man.
You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
If someone were to look at a broad spectrum of rap music, from the positive to the not so positive to the very negative, what kind of picture would they get of urban life?
A lot of police brutality. That's one element that's I find in most of the songs is oppression by the police.
Yo, Trey, what's the sound of my tool? Now you know that I'm about to act a fool. Me and you can go toe to toe, no mate. I'm knocking suckers out the box daily. Yo, weekly, monthly, and yearly.
Matter of fact, the FBI reprimanded one of these rap groups for urging violence against the police, which I don't approve of at all. Nobody would approve of that. But there is an issue there, and it deserves to be investigated, and more attention should be paid to it. And this is a classical issue in American ghettos, that black people feel they're treated differently by the police than whites, okay? Especially black men. That's not to exclude black women.
Excuse me, ma'am. Is your daughter in one of the cars?
She right there. She's sick with the measles, and they won't let me ask why they got her stuck up in that car in the first place. She's been out ever since the 8th of January. That's why she's not in school.
And now she's in a police car?
She's sitting right there in the red road. She still got her pajamas and stuff on. All they do is just harass people, and then don't nobody do nothing about it.
See, the people know me as a villain. Definition is clear, you're the witness of a killing. It's taking place without a clue. And once you're on the scope, you know you're through.
I heard the officer say she's under arrest for battery resisting arrest. After she gets out of the case, she's going to jail.
My sister told me she was trying to stop the police officer from choking my brother. And that's only right. They ain't got no business choking him in the first place. They're going to arrest you, arrest you. He ain't none of my brother's father. And he ain't none of God either. Anybody can stand on the sidewalk. You and me, anybody can stand out here on the sidewalk. It's a free street. That man don't own these streets. I don't care what the avenue is. He don't own them. I see this mess every day. They always picking with people every day. And they be parking. They'll park just like, you know, just park. And they'll sit there and they'll look. And they'll stay there for a long period of time. Then they'll drive slowly by you. Nigga, how's business going on? You SOBs and all. I mean, you know, son of a bitch. He says the word, you know. And that's not right for them to do that. If they're going to be police officers, they do it and do their job right. But God did not put them down here to judge nobody.
And the police are sort of like the judge, jury, and executioner sometimes of black people. And the civilian politicians are afraid to interfere. They always seem to take the police's version of things. I sense a lot of rage among these rap singers about the way they're treated by the police and the way any black person is treated by the police.
You won't play N.W.A., will you?
I will and I won't. In general, I don't. And that mainly has to do with the fact that I do a show, or the shows that I do, I feel that I'm reaching out to a public and I'm trying to educate them. And in doing so, I think I send out a conflicting message when I play a Martin Luther King or speech by Malcolm X, or I'm trying to sit there and say, stop the violence, and then I drop an N.W.A. that's talking about this, this, that, and the other. And I understand their perspective, but there are a lot of young, impressionable people out there that are allowed to remain impressionable because their parents don't sit down and explain to them the proper context in which to listen to music.
But isn't that censorship?
No. I mean, if I have 25 records and I only have room to play 10, 15 won't get played. One of them just happens to be N.W.A.
But isn't it's more conscious, though. You're consciously not playing N.W.A.
I consciously don't play groups that I don't like. I consciously play music that I think is not good, and that's always the subject.